With the introduction to the Lightfall expansion, in-game loadouts finally became available. Before that, you had to use Destiny Item Manager, aka DIM. DIM is fine, but the biggest issue with DIM was that you had to be in orbit or at the tower in order to equip any loadout, so no swapping mid-activity. Those days, however, are no more. And if you watch any kind of Destiny 2 content centered around builds, endgame, and damage, you've probably heard someone say, have separate loadouts for ad clear and DPS, or something like, have a loadout for mechanics and another one that you switch to for damage. If you're a seasoned D2 player, you more than likely know how to set this up correctly in your in-game loadouts, but from my experience and what I've seen, casual players usually don't know how to properly set up in-game loadouts to seamlessly hot swap through the different phases of a raid or dungeon encounter. Understanding how to set up and utilize loadouts in in-game content to maximize survivability, ammo management, and damage output is a crucial skill to have in order to take your game to the next level. However, I hardly see any videos out there that explain this in depth, so in today's video, we're gonna fix that. Jumping right in, the number one rule to follow to allow yourself to seamlessly hot swap mid-activity between your loadouts is to have the same aspects, fragments, and obviously your super for the two loadouts you want to switch between. This is important so you do not lose your super and abilities whenever you swap. Also keep in mind that your aspects and fragments need to be in the same slots in the same order. Mixing them around will also make you lose your abilities and super when you switch. And obviously, if you have completely different fragments and aspects on your different loadouts that you're swapping between, you will definitely lose your super and abilities when you swap to them. In terms of weapons, you can use the pull a green gun from collections method, so whenever you delete the green gun or blue gun, all your weapons in your loadouts will be blank. This would allow you to switch loadouts without having to worry about your weapons being switched and potentially give you more control. I personally don't do this, to be honest. I just equip whatever weapons I want to use based on the activity or encounter I'm doing and just overwrite the loadout. Up to you on how you want to approach that, but I would at least recommend you keep your heavy weapon the same on each loadout you're swapping between, and also just make sure you're not switching from a primary weapon to a special weapon because you will lose your ammo. You can switch a couple times back and forth between two special weapons and you won't really lose that much ammo, if at all, so you're good there. For example, in my ad clear and mechanics loadout, I could run forbearance for ad clear and then switch to a fusion rifle in my damage loadout when it comes time to do DPS. For exotic armor, my general rule of thumb is to use either an armor piece that can help with your ad clear and survivability potential in your mechanics loadout, or an armor piece that generates heavy ammo for you and your fire team, like Aeons or Cenotaph Mask for Warlocks. And then for your damage loadout, you ideally want to use an armor piece that enhances your super damage or supports your teammates. A few examples of this would be, for a hunter, you could use Assassin's Cowl for ad clear mechanics and then switch to Star Eater Scales for damage. For Warlocks on Well of Radiance, you could use Cenotaph Mask and then switch to Lunafactions for your damage loadout for extra reload speed in support of your team. And for Titans, a great example is to use Synthoseps for ad clear and then switch to Pyregales for damage. Moving on to mods, this is really where you can put the icing on the cake for your loadouts. There's a ton of different combinations you can create here, but my general framework for each of my mechanics and damage loadouts is roughly the same, respectively. For mechanics, starting with the helmet, I definitely would want a heavy ammo finder at the least, and maybe a scout if you can fit it. It's also a good idea to have a siphon mod and either heavy-handed or firepower on your arms as well, so you can create orbs for yourself. For chest pieces, you can run any resistances you want, and also just remember you can take a different chest piece in your inventory, put triple reserve mods on it for your heavy weapons, rally with it equipped, and then switch back to your chest piece that has your normal resistances on, and you will not lose the extra ammo. You can also do this mid-encounter too. For legs, I highly recommend using one recuperation for a flat 70 HP on orb pickup, a scavenger mod for your heavy weapon to keep yourself well supplied, and stacks on stacks to give you two armor charges for each orb you pick up instead of one. With the nerf to double special, I also recommend to run a special finisher to generate special ammo for you and your teammates on your class item. For your damage loadout, the most important thing you should equip is triple surge mods for your heavy weapon and as many time dilations as you can fit on your class item. On your gloves and helmet, you can run any targeting, dexterity, or reload mods you want for your weapons to help you with your weapon swaps and your damage output. Remember, for each of these builds with different armor pieces, you can use d2armorpicker.com to set up all your builds to customize the stats you want. I'll also have a bunch of dim links in the description for all three characters so you guys can copy some of my loadouts if you want, or at least get some inspiration for your builds. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I hope you enjoyed today's video on loadout hot swapping. If this video helped you out, please leave a like and comment and consider subscribing to the channel for more Destiny 2 tips, tricks, and guides. As a reminder, if you want to stay up to date on my content and live streams, feel free to join my Discord server. Also, if you want to join a community of Guardians to hang out with, make friends, find people to play D2 with, and get PvE help from me, feel free to join the Notorious Destiny community. We're a growing community of Guardians, welcome to those of all skill levels, links are in the description. Thanks for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.